Does the color of the sky mean anything special to you? It does to me. A hell of a lot. When I close my eyes, the sky in my dreams is a deep, dark blue. Pilots have been in my family for four generations. Flying's in my DNA. Even so, my grandpa didn't want me joining the Air Force. He lost faith in the Ocean Air Defense the day my dad died in battle.
You know, Avi, I wish you could see what it's like up there. Cruising above the clouds, the dark blue of the stratosphere. Nothing beats being at the controls and seeing it from the cockpit. Look here.
Gramps tossed a magazine over to me with an article. Unmanned fighters are no longer a dream, it read. Pilots taking to the skies will soon be a distant memory.
I don't see anything good coming from that.
Know what? Lying smack dab in the middle of the desert west of here, there's a bunch of planes from the last war. Some of them have been mothballed, but most of them are just rusted piles of junk waiting to be scrapped. Gramps was really good friends with the super there, so he got to take whatever he wanted, no questions asked. That's how we got the parts to build our own plane. Now, when I say we, I mean me, my grandpa, and his old war buddies. I cut my teeth working with those geezers. They taught me their skills and some dirty jokes. But with their aging eyeballs and whatnot, I ended up having to do most of the work myself. I was at the airstrip doing some flight training when I saw it. A prototype drone. It wasn't much of a plane, more of a trash can with wings.
Laugh at it all you want, kid. But technology's always changing. If you don't keep up with it, it'll leave your ass behind.
It took 6 years and 8 months to get that engine running. And it took us another year and a half after that to finally get the balance of the airframe just right. I'd gone from being a little girl to, well, still a girl, just older. But now, I was all alone. Wherever the souls of my gramps and his pals are flying, I hope it's peaceful. Then, finally, I was ready to break the sound barrier. All this plane could do was take off, accelerate, and fly up. Then I saw Osius fighters. They were tailing something. A drone. They were going full out chasing that thing. Doing 30 Gs at least. Damn, I've never seen anything move that fast. It had a rose painted on it. The Erusian emblem. But that country's a whole continent away from here.
Crap. It should have been my best to see this piece of junk. Should have built a turn too.
Is everyone here? Settle down. I said settle down. You have all been instrumental in helping to maintain peace in Yuzha as members of the International Union Peacekeeping Force. Until today. Earlier, Our radar site informed us that a group of unidentified aircraft was approaching. Communication systems went down immediately afterwards. We are led to conclude that they have attacked the site. Here's your mission. It's possible that the Yuuzhan ceasefire agreement has been broken for the first time in over a decade. As of today, the Fort Gray's airbase squadron of the IUPF has been put on high alert. All members who have been ordered to sortie, fly there immediately. Find the unidentified craft, then use your weapons to round them up and force them to land. If the hostiles counterattack, then you will...
What the hell was that?
There's smoke!
We're under attack. Numerous unidentified aircraft confirmed overhead.
What? How is that possible?
The tank farm to the north has been bombed!
Many injured!
Scramble! All units, take off and eliminate the unidentified craft attacking the base! This is not a drill.
Squadron, aircraft preparations complete. Stand by at the front.
Radar sight still silent. Scramble. Get those birds in the sky. We're sitting ducks.
What's happening? Bombers incoming. Don't know how many.
Let's clear that runway. We don't got all day here.
Mage Squadron, head to runway. Golem Squadron, take off. Link to Skykeeper. Hurry, Mage Squadron.
Trigger, your call sign is Mage 2. Verify and read back. Mage 2, clear for takeoff. The situation is tight. It's a hell of a welcoming party. We have faith in you. Good luck.
Control, do me a favor and get that bird in the air ASAP.
Hear that? Golem Squadron and your wingmen are airborne. Take off and form up with Mage 1. Mage 2, altitude restriction is lifted. Good luck.
The carrier. Whoa, looks like the harbor's taken a lot of damage.
Can't have any more casualties. Time to stop the bullshit. Mage 2, form up with Mage 1. All aircraft, let's do this. Golem Squadron, it's go time.
Roger that.
Golem 4, understood.
This is the AWACS Skykeeper. Take down all unidentified bombers. They don't have many escorts. They hit our radars hard in the last attack. Expect the worst and stay sharp.
Wilco.
True.
Trigger. I'm your wingman. Fly with me now. That's what it means to be in an element. You gotta keep an eye out for enemy bombers. Okay, here we go. Looks like bombers have been located.
Box 2.
It's showtime, Trigger. Let's see if you can handle the spotlight.
Enemy bomber confirmed down. Good job, Mage 2.
Not bad, Mage 2. Trigger, switch your radar. See if you can locate the enemy. There it is, sitting there all pretty, just waiting to be taken.
Targets in range. Parabombers.
Trigger, stay calm. You got this. I know the kid's showing some promise, but let's remember, he's still barely gotten his feet wet.
one sticking to my back. Warning, enemy in your six.
One remaining.
Mage 2, keep your focus. You got this.
Stall warning.
To Golem and Mage, job well done. All bombers are down. Our radar shows no sign of bandits. You're in the clear.
Going, Mage 2. Flight Commander looks like he's got what it takes.
Let's slow down. It's just one sortie. Don't try to be a hero. I want you to make it back in one piece, you hear?
Yeah, I gotta side with the boss man on this.
Golem Squadron, this is HQ. Did you confirm any drones?
What's the deal with all the drones?
Golem 1, return to base and report for debriefing.
Sign is Mage 2. Verify and read back. Mage 2, clear for takeoff. Situation is tight.
We are currently assessing the damage to the base. We have confirmed that the aircraft carrier Albatross was sunk. We know the attacking bogeys were from Arusha. International Union peacekeeping force bases all over the Yuzhan continent were attacked in the same way. The damage is severe. Many wars are lost by failing to recover from the opening blows. That means successfully retaliating. You have our thanks.
As of 1 p.m. today, the Kingdom of Arusia has declared war on the Ocean Federation. As soon as the news broke out, enemy aircraft began bombing Ocean territory, causing widespread destruction. The Air Defense Force has released a statement saying this violent attack was carried out by drones. They speculate the drones were secretly transported to Ocea in shipping containers and launched remotely. The Secretary of the Navy has stated that the enemy was targeting naval ports across the country. According to the Secretary, all of the nation's aircraft carriers, including one still under construction, sustained severe damage in the attacks. We have yet to hear back from the Department as to the fate of Ocean carriers currently at sea. Hold on. I've just received breaking news. The International Space Elevator, which is being built in southern Yuzha, has been seized by the Arusian Army. Reports say former President Harling was touring the site at the time, but his current whereabouts are unknown. Our sources in government tell us it was Harling's policies regarding the space elevator that caused economic frictions in the area, and which ultimately led to this war. Located near Arusha, on the continent of Yuzha, the space elevator has been under construction for some time now. The Executive Office of the Ocean Federation has declared a national state of emergency. They have ordered all its armed forces, including Yuzhan peacekeepers, to mobilize and make the necessary preparations to launch an immediate counterattack. Ladies and gentlemen, our country is officially at war. Stay tuned for further updates.
Breaking news from ENN. Ocea launched an attack on the capital today, striking Farbanti from their aircraft carrier, the Kestrel II. After a brutal battle, the Arusian Air Force successfully repelled them. During the air raid, the Ocean Air Force fired missiles at the city and managed to shoot down a number of Erujian fighters. Some of the disabled planes then crashed into residential areas.
The world was screwed. 20 years ago, the Earth got slammed by an asteroid. Yuzha was on the wrong side of the planet and got hit. Hard. Refugees swarmed the Erujian Republic, the biggest country on the continent, plunging it into chaos. They were desperate and started a war, one they had no hope of winning. That's the war my dad fought and died in. The biggest nations from two continents went head to head, and the so-called righteous Oceans struck the deal that ended it. They fancied themselves the only nation that could bring peace and stability to the world. They even tried saving the Yuzhans, still suffering from the disaster. That's how a space elevator, stretching way up into the sky, ended up being built in Yuzha, paid for by the Oceans. President Harling said he did it out of compassion for his fellow humans. But to the folks in Erujia, it looked like Osea was moving in to take over. Erujia went from being a republic back to being a kingdom. When they started this new war, they managed to get the drop on everyone. The second the declaration hit the news, Erujian forces took control of the space elevator without spilling a single drop of blood. President Harling was touring the elevator when it happened and disappeared. Then, while that was going on, the Erujian ships that were docked all around Osea released a swarm of drone fighters they had hidden on board in containers. No one thought they were capable of doing what they did that day. With pinpoint accuracy, they managed to take out everything that was military, and not a single civilian was hurt in the process. Osea pissed lots of people off with their huge military presence around the world. Erujia didn't have the same reach, but they could hit their targets faster and cleaner. And when all this was going down, I just so happened to be in my flying drag racer. In case you were wondering, yeah, I survived. I crashed in a bombed-out Ocean Air Force base, then got arrested for breaking wartime aviation laws or some crap. The world went from being at peace to being at war, all in the blink of an eye. I was tried, found guilty, and stuffed into a cargo ship. For company, I had some court-martialed soldiers. And remember those mothballed planes I told you about before? They were loaded on the ship, too. We headed off down south for several days, and then swung east. That's how I got here. I was thousands of kilometers from Erujia, on the opposite side of the Yuzhan continent. For a port, it was dull as hell. It had three rusty patrol boats. And the base? The fences were topped with razor wire, the tower had a searchlight and machine guns, and a truck with a gun turret was parked in front of the gate. Its gun was aimed at the yard. This was a prison. This place looked like a full-on base, but half the tanker trucks were just big balloons, and the runways weren't even paved, just painted on the dirt. The whole place was just one big, fat lie. The only reason I was here is because they knew I'd restored a supersonic plane. They wanted me to make something out of the mothballed planes they brought, that they could park on the fake runway. Can you believe that shit? So, I tried to escape. They found out. And set the dogs on me.
Arusia has made a declaration to the Ocean Federation and all countries on the Yuzhan continent stationing the IUN peacekeeping force that we are now at war. Right after the declaration was made, surprise attacks began around the continent that have inflicted major damage to our armed forces. Forces aligned with Arusia are currently appearing throughout Yuzhan. The combination of these forces has overwhelmed the majority of the continent, and they are now encroaching on us in the east. Additionally, the multinational space elevator has been seized by the Arusian military. After the previous war, the space elevator became both a symbol of peace and a valuable asset in the fight against growing energy concerns. Whoever has control of it will have enormous influence over the entire continent. We cannot turn a blind eye to this critical situation. The Fort Gray's Air Base Squadron has been entered into the order of battle to reclaim the elevator as an advance element. First, you will attack all hostiles coming in the east of Schofield Plateau to stop any interference with the Allied ground troops. The enemy has deployed several vehicles equipped with anti-air radar along the roads. You are to destroy them. They should not pose much of a threat. However, there is a high likelihood that the attack will draw more enemy air support. If that happens, fight them off swiftly and establish air superiority.
Squadron, sortie ASAP.
Current target is on rails, but there's still military vehicles and anti-air weaponry. Destroy the target. But HQ has made it clear that no harm should come to civilians and no damage is to be done to public facilities.
But, any aircraft shot down could land in civilian territory.
No point arguing. That's how war is these days.
Do you have visual on the anti-air radar vehicles? They should be close.
Yep.
Targeting gun range.
destroyed. Five to go.
Get the fighters out there! Protect the radar vehicle!
H2, missile launch.
Target destruction on the vehicle! We can't wait any longer. We need interceptors now. Where's our support? If we get some fighters soon, the whole base is gone!
Target destroyed. Three to go. Continue to engage at your discretion. Enemy interceptors inbound. Prepare to engage in 30 seconds.
Wilco, here they come. Take them down.
Okay, recruits. Pay attention to who's on what side. The newest IFF is connected to our entire force via satellites. It's reliable, so trust your radars. Target destroyed.
Targets remaining.
Missile hit.
We aim over clear ground.
Scope
Box 2.
I'm cornered.
Lock broken by the clouds.
All aircraft, residential area is below you.
Missile fire, evading.
On radar. They're close.
Wait, they're being launched.
You're clear to engage. They're probably hostile.
Judging by the way they look,
they gotta be drones.
Well spotted, clown. No doubt about it, we're dealing with UAVs. But that doesn't change a thing. Just think of them as somewhat clever decoys. Take them all down. These drones have great agility. All aircraft. You know what high G turns are, right? Use them.
HQ, this is Golem 1. Bandits confirmed as UAVs. Repeat, bandits are drones.
Bandits are in the clouds!
Golem 1, that doesn't matter. Destroy all enemy fighters and get out.
It doesn't matter. He's saying the war can change in an instant. Get over it.
Yeah, I just wish they'd give us a bit more warning.
Page 2, missile away. Missile did not connect.
on his tail. He dodged it. Gollum Squadron, surround him.
Trigger. Enemy aircraft confirmed down.
The skies are clear. Nice work, everyone. Mission complete. RTB.
No casualties. We couldn't have done any better. Returning to base.
I don't know. Maybe the bandits we took down caused civilian casualties.
No point arguing. That's how war is these days.
You shoot, someone gets killed. The guys in charge take care of the rest.
Current target is on rails.
You've given us air superiority by destroying their radar. The first barrier keeping us from retaking the space elevator is gone. Now is the time to group up and begin the counteroffensive. Let us reclaim what is ours. Surprise attacks carried out after the declaration of war saw the peacekeeping forces of various countries, including Osea, suffer major damage. The ships moored around the space elevator and near Gandar Bay have been hit particularly hard. Numerous ships have been sunk and abandoned. Fortunately, our cutting-edge aircraft carrier, Kestrel II, was at sea, so it was spared from the attack. Kestrel II is now preparing to launch another attack against Arugia's capital, Barbanti. The aircraft carrier Vulture also managed to escape Gandhar Bay safely. However, it lost all its aircraft, so it's sailing empty. Today, the International Union Peacekeeping Force reclaims its bid to the space elevator. The Fort Grays Island Air Base Squadron will rendezvous with the carrier Vulture for a joint mission. The first objective will be to seize air superiority in Choppenburg in order to secure a route for the support squadrons. The enemy maintains air superiority over Choppenburg, so expect heavy resistance from enemy aircraft. There's more, so listen carefully. Right from the start of the war, the enemy has been deploying drones. They're using a new advanced type of drone. The unmanned airborne aircraft carrier, the Arsenal Bird, carries this new drone, MQ-101. The Ocean Army headed up the development of the massive Arsenal Birds and dispatched them to the space elevator to provide support. However, it's been reported that the carriers may have fallen into the hands of the Erusian forces. If that's true, it could be a significant obstacle for us. We need to regain control of the space elevator ASAP. Good luck out there.
Squadron, aircraft preparations complete.
Squadron, this is the situation. Gollum and the other base's squadrons already joined forces and are engaged. You guys will arrive right in the middle of the action. Mage Squadron, eliminate all bandits in the current airspace. We have the upper hand, but that doesn't mean we can ease up. Good luck.
Mage 1, Wilco. Mage 1 to Gollum 1, thank your lucky stars.
Looking good, Mage Squadron. Keep up that pressure.
Trigger, time to show the other guys that we get wet, wild, and do dirty, dirty things.
Once you hit one of them, stick to him like glue. Don't let him out of your sights, even in the clouds.
And so, your first hunting season begins.
This right here is what we call a learning experience.
Roger that.
I'm in his blind spot. He's
missile. Use chaff and flares. Your fingers should still move, even if you're in a 9G turn.
Shows no sign of bandits. You're in the clear.
Woohoo! I haven't even broken a sweat.
They would be crazy to pick a fight with us. A rabid dog would know better.
Missile incoming! Invade! Break! Break!
Wait, what the hell?
Caution! Missile!
Caution! Large aircraft is approaching. All aircraft, stay alert.
Missile!
Destroy the arsenal bird.
Missile.
What's that thing?
God help us.
Trigger, they're machines. Don't show
Foxy. Fox 2.
Gollum and Mage 1, help us.
Get those UAVs off of friends.
Let
Gollum and Mage Squadron handle it. They'll pull through.
Get your asses out. Hell of a good job, Mage 2. We want as many guys out here as possible.
I'm grateful you're around.
Gollum 2, what's your status? Status report.
He's a predator. The weak can eat.
Gollum 2, get a hold of yourself. Gollum 2, get away from the enemy.
Mage 2, support! Somebody! Support!
I said what I had to say. About what? Not a girl who'd retreat. Just not in her DNA. That was the right decision at the time. No, I should have never let a fledgling like her out of my reach to begin with.
Gollum Squadron, Mage Squadron, withdraw.
Nicely done, Mage 2.
I knew you'd be back. Stand by for further orders. Be ready for your next sortie.
Mage Squadron, this is the situation. Gollum and the other base's squadrons already joined forces and are engaged. You guys will arrive right in the middle of the action. Mage Squadron, eliminate all bandits in the current airspace.
Unfortunately, the two-front offensive was a failure. The aircraft carrier Kestrel II was sunk during the attack on Farbanti. Carrier-borne aircraft mistakenly bombed urban areas, and this has turned public opinion in neutral countries against us. Our own forces also suffered heavy losses. If it weren't for a few extraordinary fighters, many of us wouldn't have... The situation is grim. We have precious little time, however. We have to get...
comes. Mihai's looking worse. Thank God he has his granddaughters here to help him out. They're sisters, 15 and 10. Engaging the enemy in combat so we could use his physiological data to improve the drones had always taken a toll on Mihai's body. But today, he was really showing his age. The drones we based on his data were being taken down at a faster rate now compared to when the war began. When Mihai found that out, he insisted on flying to the front lines to see it for himself. Sometimes he could be so stubborn. His age wasn't the only thing affecting his health. Over the years, flying at high altitudes for prolonged stretches of time had ravaged and poisoned his body. But he was a man of grit. Today, after 28 years, he saw combat again. If his flight suit still wasn't good enough to protect him, I can't imagine how many G's he hit today during the battle. As a pilot, he exceeds all our expectations. It's going to take a bit more tweaking before our drones can match his skill.
How penal is this penal unit, you ask? This place is a shithole. If you took the stink of all the corruption in the world, then corralled it all in one place, that would give you a pretty good idea of what the air smells like around here. We got all kinds of critters, too. Everything from flea-ridden guards, rabid dogs, and a mechanic doing a stretch for life. I can't forget the rats. Yeah, we got those. And some pilots who got their wings clipped, too. One's a great pilot, but a lousy thief. One's a gambler with no luck. And one's an anarchist with no balls. Their job here was to rev the engines on the fake runways. The idea was for Aruja's spy satellite to pick up the heat sig. Even though there weren't any real fighters here, it looked like it on their infrared. I bet you're wondering, if Aruja lost the war, how come they still have a spy satellite? Because someone over there was smart enough to train a bunch of computer nerds to hack into half of Osea's satellites. That's how come. Every now and again, I'd try to bust out. And every single time, those damn dogs would drag me right back. When I was in my cell, I'd hear this voice coming from the guards room. It was the Arusian princess rallying her people on the Arusian national broadcast. All us prisoners had become big fans of hers. You want to hear something funny? The guards were big fans, too. I swear to God, every time she was on the air, they'd turn up the volume on the radio and sit there listening. I could see how someone like her could win the hearts and minds of soldiers and workers alike. When the princess said something, you could tell she meant every word. Lately, she'd been having more fun with her speeches, and that made her seem even more charming. You could say her charm was like a virus. Whenever she'd point out stuff that was wrong with Osea, the prisoners in here went nuts. Hell, if anyone knew how messed up Osea was, it was the prisoners. They'd shout, "Burn Osea down." No way am I just gonna sit here and rot away in this hellhole. Dark blue. Instead of building fake-ass planes to trick Aruja, I'm gonna build one that'll really take off. You can count on that.
As proved by the failure of our previous strategy, the Arsenal Birds have bolstered the enemy's anti-air network. This will be difficult to overcome. However, we still need to get swiftly to the space elevator no matter what it takes. Someone there is counting on us. The hero of the Circum-Pacific War and the man who spearheaded the construction of the space elevator. Osea's former president, Mr. Harling. Mr. Harling was inspecting the elevator when the war broke out. He's been classified as missing since the elevator was taken over by the Arusian forces. However, according to the latest intel, a military officer accompanying Mr. Harling hid him inside the facility. Both are waiting for a chance to escape. Enemy anti-air radar network has been set up around the space elevator. It's likely a large squadron would be detected. We will send a single aircraft through the network and send in a rescue team soon after. A number of anti-air radars have been set up around the space elevator. However, our reconnaissance suggests their network is weakest along the southeastern coast of Selatapura. So we can elude the enemy's observation. There are a lot of rain clouds this time of year. Flying through the clouds will enable us to stay hidden from their radar. If you happen to be detected by their radar, we will be forced to abort the mission. The lone pilot who will head up this strategy is you, Trigger. After you bust through, secure the rescue craft's landing zone by taking out the anti-air weapons. Gollum and others will arrive shortly for support. Provide escort for Mr. Harling's craft after rendezvous. Good luck out there, everyone.
Aircraft preparations complete. Sortie ASAP.
Entering operation area. Imposing radio silence. We'll radio you, but you are not permitted to make contact.
If you're spotted, the mission is over. Stay out of enemy radar. Use of weaponry is also strictly forbidden. Okay, you're heading up the Harling rescue mission. The success of this mission depends on you. Good luck. Formation in the clouds. Trigger, you're a third of the way to the rendezvous point. Good job, but stay focused. Progress, Trigger. You're currently halfway to your rendezvous point. Look, I'm not gonna lie. It's just gonna be you and your radar out there. Just know, you got a bunch of people pulling for you. And I'm one of them.
situation report. Something's happening. Nothing to report here. Everything's quiet.
You're 3/4 of the way. It's been a long fight, but you're nearly home. Harling is still the president in my eyes. He ended the war, built the space elevator, and launched a spaceship from it. Despite his success, he remained a humble hero. I'll do my best to save him. Lend me a hand, Trigger. Rendezvous point dead ahead. Hang in there. Trigger, the first stage of the mission is clear. Don't celebrate yet. The real fight's about to get started. Radio silence is now lifted. The auxiliary craft will be arriving shortly. Destroy the anti-air around the space elevator. We're securing Sea Goblin's landing zone. Sights are down.
Adios, buddy.
Damn, I'm spiked.
Mage 2, target down. All anti-air guns destroyed. Destroy the remaining SAM sites and secure the LZ.
Missile
inbound, evade!
All SAM sites down. The landing zone is secure. Sea Goblin, you are clear to land.
Roger. Rendezvous point in sight. We're almost there.
Multiple bandits over Selatapura Harbor. Their container launched UAVs.
Sea Goblin here. We're going up to meet our two VIPs.
Rescue craft tagged on.
Rescue craft on the ground is defenseless. Golem and Mage, destroy all hostiles.
It's been a long journey, but you're on the home stretch.
Gargoyle will stand by near the space elevator.
This is Sea Goblin. Heading over to the Express's location now. Run for the container!
The enemy has a lock on you, Mage 2. UAV confirmed down.
Enemy's got a lock.
one remaining. Missile away. Target was not struck. South. Provide support. 5 minutes remaining.
Skykeeper, bogey's on my radar. Bearing 220.
Sighting confirmed as MQ-101. Forerunner for Arsenal Bird.
The big bird is coming, huh?
Mage, protect Mother Goose 1. Shoot down any UAVs. Gollum, intercept the UAVs.
Gollum 1 will kill. That last battle taught me a lot about those a-holes. Gollum 2, don't stray off on me. Always maintain element.
Wilco, forming up.
Missile away.
Enemies locked. Gollum 4, enemy behind you.
Enemy UAV down. Great job, Trigger.
Roger. Sending UAV to the transport.
Fox 2!
Orders are to fire warning.
This didn't connect.
Yes, sir. He's an old-timer. Has no clue how UAVs are used.
Mother Goose 1, UAV on your tail. Take evasive action.
I hear you. But this isn't exactly a fighter.
Understood. An Arsenal Bird is on its way. Strategic AI chose liberty over justice. The courses have already changed.
Enemy UAV down. Keep up the good work.
Okay, Fox 2.
Mage 2, down any UAVs near Mother Goose 1. Mother Goose 1 has been shot down. Squadron, Mother Goose 1 is heading south. Provide support.
Skykeeper, bogey's on my radar. Bearing 220.
Sighting confirmed as MQ-101. Forerunner for Arsenal Bird.
The big bird is coming, huh?
Mage, protect Mother Goose 1. Shoot down any UAVs. Gollum, intercept the UAVs.
Golem 1 will kill. That last battle taught me a lot about those a-holes. Golem 2, don't stray off on me. Always maintain element.
Wilco, warming up!
Trigger, enemy UAV down. Nice work. Keep it up. UAV launched.
Fox 2! Fox 2!
Roger. Transport. Orders are to fire warnings.
Mother Goose 1, UAV on your tail. Take evasive action.
I hear you, but this isn't exactly a fighter.
Mage 2, Fox 2.
Understood. An Arsenal Bird is on its way. Strategic AI chose liberty over justice. Courses have already changed.
Gargoyle 1, where's the signal? Gargoyle Squadron, stand by for my order.
Gargoyle 3 to Babel.
Babel, roger.
Squadron. Assess the situation.
This is Mage 1. I have Marcus 1 in my sight. Cabin's fine, but the cockpit's not looking so good.
Colonel Johnson, are you okay?
Don't worry about that. Just send help this way. I'm sorry. Can Mr. Army? Please.
Mother Goose 1, respond. Mother Goose 1.
Skykeeper, should we continue providing cover for Mother Goose 1?
Of course.
Lock acquired. Gullum 4, bandit on your ass!
Mother Goose 1 is turning. What's going on? They're heading to the space elevator.
Flying at a steady altitude. Who's in control?
It's not the Colonel. Mr. Harling's the only one on board. Mother Goose 1, respond! Mr. Harling, please respond!
We can't protect our objective if it sticks around here. Now's not the time to freak out, fellas. We've still got a job to do, so let's do it. Keep your mind focused.
Mr. Harling, we are not giving up on you. The UAVs are approaching Mother Goose 1.
Let's go, Trigger.
Take him down now, Mage Squadron. 1 minute remaining. Mother Goose 1, turn 180 degrees and exit combat.
Mage 2, Mage 2.
Oh my god, Mother Goose 1 has been shot down.
Where'd the missile come from?
Mage 2 fired that.
It was OG. A friendly missile hit him.
Verifying the situation. Stop speculating.
Friendly fire. I saw it.
Mother Goose 1 exploded in air. No one could have survived.
Looks like it tried to protect the elevator. Erosian bastards, they just killed a hero.
Mage 1, was it Trigger? Trigger was the closest. UAVs were crawling all over our objective. I told you to keep a goddamn eye on the hatchling. It must have been a mistake.
Arsenal Bird is entering. All aircraft withdraw immediately.
Trigger, you can't fly for a while. You understand?
The operation to rescue former President Harling has failed. Sadly, there is no hope he survived. Trigger, you are suspected of assassinating a former president. There will be an inquiry. There will most probably be a court-martial.